In this video, we're going to be going over the drop shadow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics. Here I got some artwork drawn out, and I'm going to come over here to the STYLISM panel. This section here has all the different effects you could apply onto your artwork. So while I have my artwork selected, I'm going to come to this first option here, which is the drop shadow. Once I click on this button, it automatically applies this drop shadow onto my artwork. And it also activated the STYLISM tool here on my tools panel. If we take a look over here in the appearance panel, you see all it did so far was add the native drop shadow that you're used to using in Adobe Illustrator. I'll hide the appearance panel and then come over here to my artwork. So with STYLISM, we have this annotation system where you could just click and drag, and when you release, you see your drop shadow has been updated. So I could just come along here and make some really quick, intuitive edits. Now right now I'm freely just transforming this guy, but if I introduce the shift key, you see it'll actually constrain it to these specific angles for me. I'll bring it right around here. Now if I wanted to change the color of my drop shadow, I just have to click on this guy here and it brings up the color picker. In here I could choose a new color, and when I click OK, you see it automatically updates here on my artboard. Now this is the normal mode, but if you hover over this guy, hold down the Alt key and click on it, it changes it to darkness mode. The annotation here is showing you that it's at 100%. So if I click on the thumbnail, I have this new panel here. I'll make some changes, and when I click OK, you see it's reflected here on my artwork. Now if I want to go back to the normal mode, just Alt click on it, and it brings you back to this color picker mode. Along with the color, you also have a blending mode option here. So I have this drop down menu with all these different blending modes you're used to seeing. I'll leave it set to multiply, and then come over here to this blur handle. If I click on it, and bring it in towards the center, you see it brings the blur value down to 0 pixels. So when I release, I have this nice crisp line going across this drop shadow here. If I click and drag and bring it towards the edge, you see it now it's maxed out at 144 pixels. And then when I release, you see it's fully blurred my drop shadow here on my artwork. Now if I want to make some more edits to this, all I have to do is click and drag. But for some edits, the slider can move a little bit too fast. So if you want to make more precise edits, just hold down the Command key and you see it'll slow it down for you. When I release, you see I got this nice drop shadow here. So just keep in mind, click, drag, and then introduce the Command key. And then you'll be able to make some more precise edits that way. This last slider we have here is for the opacity. If I click and drag and bring it to the edge, you see it's at 100%. When I release, it's nice and dark right here. And now if I click and drag and bring it in towards the center, you see it brings the opacity down to 0%, and when I release, it's completely gone. So with my workflow, what I like to do is bring it to 0% and then slowly bring it back in until I get the look I'm going for. All right, so far I've been showing you how to use these different sliders, but you could also double click on the handles and it'll bring up these panels so you could introduce a specific value. So right here I want it to be at 70%, and you see it's reflected here on the annotation. I'll come over here to this handle, double click on the blur, set the blur to 10 pixels, click OK, and you see it's updated there. Now when I come to this handle, I'll double click on it, it gives me the X and Y offsets. And then what's really cool is I could also make changes by entering specific distance, or I could enter in a specific angle. When I click OK, you see it's updated over here. STYLISM takes care of all the math for you. Now let's come over here to this panel again. In here, we have a resolution associated with this effect. You can manually enter in a new resolution, or you could use these presets to change it from 300 ppi to 72 ppi when editing. Down here at the bottom, because I have Phantasm installed on my system, I could actually make edits to this curve and get a little subtle look here, where I could just feather this guy off a little bit. See, I got a nice fade going on here, or I could start adding more of these anchor points and get some really dramatic effects. Please be sure to check out the future videos on resolution and Phantasm to get full use out of your STYLISM panel. And that's the drop shadow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics.